Welcome to The Know. I'm Brian.
I'm Ben.
It's no secret that a lot of countries have been individually looking into whether or not loot boxes violate their gambling laws. It's been a huge controversy, huge kind of a worldwide phenomenon.
Right, but now a bunch of regulators from around the world, including one state in the US, say they're going to band together to address the issue.
That could be a big headache for the big gaming publishers who make a ton of money from loot boxes in games like FIFA and the NBA 2K games, Battlefront, just to name a very few.
Yeah, this could change everything when it comes to loot boxes and microtransactions in gaming.
Apparently, they're not only going to look at loot boxes, but even like third-party sites that engage in skin betting too, and also something they call social casino gaming.
All right, so it looks like some people might be finally cracking down on microtransaction loot boxes. Yep. This comes from the UK Gambling Commission, which joined with other regulators and issued a declaration today about their concerns with what they called blurring the lines between gambling and gaming.
And there's a bunch of participating countries and governments, including Austria, the Czech Republic, France, Gibraltar, Ireland, the Isle of Man, Jersey, Latvia, Malta, the Netherlands, Norway, Poland, Portugal, Spain, the United Kingdom, and the Washington State Gambling Commission here in the U.S. Do not ask me to point all those places out on a map.
They have a regular blood pact going for these things.
I'm a dumb American.
In their statements, they wrote, "We are increasingly concerned with the risks being posed by the blurring of lines between gambling and other forms of digital entertainment, such as video games. Concerns in this area have manifested themselves in controversies related to skin betting, loot boxes, social casino gaming, and the use of gambling-themed content within video games available for children."
Uh-oh, that's a no-no. They compared some of the characteristics to online gambling, which of course, few years back, led to regulators around the world getting involved.
They went on to say, "We commit ourselves today to working together to thoroughly analyze the characteristics of video games and social gaming. This common action will enable an informed dialogue with the video games and social gaming industries to ensure the appropriate and efficient implementation of our national laws and regulations."
They also said they'll work with consumer protection enforcement authorities, and they issued a bit of a warning to video game developers and publishers, saying that it will be in their interest to engage with gambling regulatory authorities to develop possible solutions.
Interesting. Variety quoted Neil MacArthur, chief executive of the UK's Gambling Commission, who said, "We have joined forces to call on video game companies to address the clear public concern around the risks gambling and some video games can pose to children. We encourage video game companies to work with their gambling regulators and take action now to address those concerns to make sure that consumers and particularly children are protected."
So, what does this all mean? Let's break it down.
Let's do it. Well, it's definitely a big escalation when it comes to possible regulation of some of the monetization practices in gaming today. And by combining forces, especially throughout Europe, you can bet that the gaming industry is going to pay attention.
It's a huge market. It also sounds like they are politely telling developers, either start working with us or we're going to crack down.
It's not a threat. It's not a threat.
Right, but it's just going to happen.
Right. Of course, there have been investigations in countries all over the world into whether or not loot boxes constitute illegal gambling.
Yeah, they've been kind of all over the map. In some countries like Belgium and the Netherlands, regulators have decided that loot boxes are the same thing as gambling. And those countries basically issued an ultimatum to developers, either change or you're going to face fines and other penalties.
And most developers listened and complied. Blizzard now has locked the sale of loot boxes in Belgium for games like Overwatch and Heroes of the Storm.
And in Dota 2, Dutch players noticed that the loot boxes in that game, they now just reveal the contents before they purchase. They're not like invisible at all.
Cool, I'd be down for that.
Yeah.
EA, on the other hand, has resisted the ruling in Belgium and could be headed to court.
But we should note, not every country agrees with Belgium and the Netherlands. Regulators in the UK and New Zealand also have looked into loot boxes and decided that they don't meet their legal definitions for gambling, but they still voice some concerns.
Right, we've also seen China force game publishers to reveal the odds behind loot boxes.
But this is the first time there's been like a coordinated effort to look into loot boxes and other monetization schemes. Also pretty significant that it's an international effort as well.
Right, it's no secret that gamers aren't big fans of loot boxes and other microtransactions, especially when they're in full-priced games, but publishers make a lot of money from loot boxes.
A lot.
And for some of them, it represents the majority of the revenue.
Yeah, it's not a side thing. It's the main thing for a lot of them. But as time has gone on, more and more countries have been hearing complaints from players and from parents who feel like their children have been victimized by these types of tactics. That's a lot of the times that is kind of a trigger trigger for government. When kids are affected, then they start to crack down.
Right. This also feels kind of like a replay of the early 90s when the U.S. government started investigating video games with violent or other mature content.
Ah, Mortal Kombat and Night Trap. Those were the days. Yeah, that's when developers and publishers, they formed their own ratings boards like the ESRB in an attempt to regulate themselves before the government got involved.
Right. So maybe we'll see something similar with loot boxes. As for now, the only thing we know is that a lot of countries are now taking this issue very seriously, and they've now started to work together to find a solution to the issue.
What do you guys think of a bunch of regulators coming together from around the world to address loot boxes? Is this a good thing? Let us know in the comments.
And for all your gaming news, be sure to like this video, and if you're new around here, subscribe to the Know.
Weak ass clap.
Yes, do it better. There we go.
Gunshot.
We are increasingly concerned with the risks being posed by the blurring of lines between... I thought I fucked up that word. I didn't. I can read.
Saying that it will be in their interest to engage with gambling